Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to see another interesting SQL question. So the question is, you have a table called logins where you have multiple columns, user ID and login date, and you have multiple users, and for each user you have a login dates. So the output is, you need to show the columns user ID, start date and end date. And if you see the input and output, so here I haven't added the third user ID data because it's become very lengthy. So I just added 1 and 2 users ID in the data, and you can observe the output and try to understand what is the logic here. So you have one user ID 1 with start date as Jan 1st and start end date as Jan 3rd. So start date as Jan 1st and end date as Jan 3rd, and user ID 1 again start date as 5 and end date as 7, 5 and 7. And if you see again user ID 2, you have a start date as Jan 1st, end date as February 1st and end date as February 4th, and you do not have this 10 and 11 again, and user ID 3 has some start and end date. So try to analyze the logic, understand, or try to think of this as a puzzle and understand the logic. So if you are able to understand the logic understand the question, try to solve it on your own. If not, let's go back to SQL Server Studio and see how to solve this or how to get this. So this is the input data as discussed, logins. So from what I understand from the initial data is, you have the start date and end date, and if you see here, start date and end date is basically you are getting the start date and end date based on the consecutive data. So that means if you are logged in on 1st of January and the third login is on January 3rd and you do not have a login on 4th. So that means this entire data set is a single data set, and you are having the start date and end date here. And similarly for 5, 6, 7 also you are having a start date and end date. And for user ID 2, you have a start date as 1st and end date as 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And 10 and 11 also is a consecutive data, but you do not have show that start date and end date. And for user ID 3, you have 3, 4, 3, 4, 5 and 7, but you are showing only 3 to 5 because this is a consecutive data. So what we understood is, we need to group the data first. So how do we group the data? Let's see. But you need to group the data, and from each group of the each group, you group the data based on consecutive logins. So once you create the group, you retrieve the maximum login date and minimum login date. So now let's see based on this logic if you are able to get this data. So how do you group it? Simple. Let's use the row number concept, and we also have to use the date add and date diff functions. So first, I'll simply create the row number, select from logins, and here I'll write user ID comma login date comma row number row underscore number over partition by user ID order by login date as rn. Okay, so we have created the row number. Now let's see how we are getting the output. So simple row number based on the user ID and order by login date. Now what we'll try to do, we'll try to create the group number. So group number, how do we create? So I will take the sample. I'll take a date, minimum date 1900-01-01. So this is January 1st of 1900. I have taken this date, and I'll try to add the number of days to this date. So whatever is the value of the rank or the row number, I'll try to add those many days to this particular day. So how do I add those many days? We have to use the concept of date add function. Date add of the parameters are day, comma start date is 1900, this one, and parameter is day. We have to add it in days. So first parameter is day, and second parameter is how many days you want to add. So this is these many number of days, we'll add it. And once the third parameter is to what date you want to add. So to this date you want to add these many number of days. Okay, and I'll keep this as rn underscore date. Okay, so now if you run this, this is what you get. So for first column you get Jan 2nd, Jan 3rd, Jan 4 and Jan 5, right? And here you get Jan 6, Jan 7 and so on, right? So 2, 3, 4, 5. So now what I will do, I will try to calculate the number of days difference between the login date and the RN date. Okay. So, how do we calculate the date difference? We use the date diff function, date diff of. So, we want the difference to be number of days, comma start date is whatever is this RN date, we will keep this as a parameter, and and the end date is the login date, login date as group. Okay. So, this if you run, let us see what we are getting. So, days is not a recognized date diff option. Okay, I think this is day, not days. So, if you see some number of days are assigned. So, so if you see for the first row, which is starting on Jan 1st and ending on Jan 3, 1, 2 and 3. So, one group number is assigned, and for 5, 6 and 7, one group number is assigned. For 1, 2, 3 and 4, one group number is assigned. So, wherever you see, wherever you are seeing consecutive dates, one separate group number is assigned. Basically, this is group number is nothing but the number of days between the login date and this particular date add which function which we have used. So, you need not start in 1900, you can start at whatever day you want, but for better understanding, I have kept this date. Okay. Now, if you see for consecutive days, you have created the group, right. So, now let us what we will try to do for every UserID and group combination, we will get the maximum login date and the minimum login date. Okay. So, how do we get that? Let us use CTE with CTE as select UserID, comma group, comma max of login date, sorry, first we want the start date. So, start date is min, right. So, here it is min, min of start date as, sorry, min of login date as start date, and comma max of login date as end date from CTE. So, we need to use the group by, group by user ID comma group, and now if you run this, let us see what we are getting. So, for every user ID, so in the output we do not have this particular group, right, this is a calculated column from our end. So, you can remove this group from the select query, but you should not remove this group from the group by, you need to remove only from the select query. So, if you run this, let us see. So, Jan user ID 1, start date is Jan 1st and end date is Jan 3, and start date is Jan 5 and end date is Jan 7. So, this is for user ID 1, the data is fine, and for user ID 2, Jan 1st and Jan 4 you are getting, which is fine, but Jan 10 to 11 is missing. Okay. And again for user ID 3, you are getting 1 to 1, which is start date and end date is 1 and 1, which is not required, and end date and 3 and 5, start date 3 and end date 5 is there. So, this is required, but and again 7 to 7 is there, which is also not required. Okay. So, somehow we need to remove this column, now we need to remove this row, row number 4 and row number 6 and 7. So, how do we remove this? So, what we will do, let us do one more thing, let us use a date diff function, date diff of days, day comma min of login date comma max of login date as diff, let us keep this as a diff. Now, let us try to understand how to remove that unnecessary data. Okay, some bracket is missing. So, if you run this, so wherever for user ID 1, date diff 2 is these two rows are coming. So, date diff is 2, which is fine, and this is also coming, which is 3, which is fine, and this 10 and 11 is 10 to 11, diff is 1, this is not required, and this is also not required, 0, 0, and this is also not required. So, if you see in this data, basically you need to filter out the data wherever you see the difference less than 2. So basically if the start date and end date difference between the start date and end date should be greater than or equal to 2 days. So you need to basically filter out the data where the difference is less than 2 days. So now let's keep this in one more CT2S and select from CT2 where diff less than, sorry, diff greater than or equal to 2, and here I will keep UserID comma start date comma end date. So this is how you need to analyze how to get the required output. So now entire output, our output is matching with the output which is requested. So this is how you need to understand the logic which is behind this output, how to derive this output. So hope you all understood the question and also like the solution. So if you like this, please click on like button and also click on subscribe button for more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.